Wow. Paralyzing. Paralyzing satanic dogs.
Praise the Lord.
I want you to know that we have satanic dogs. It is in the Bible now. This is a church that we believe salvation is not fanfare. Salvation is warfare. Praise the Lord. For you to become what God has called you to do, or for you to become what God initiated from the beginning, you have to wage war. Praise the Lord. You have to wage war. And when you wage war, is when you realize that they are satanic dogs. Praise the Lord. Read for us the book of Philippians. Philippians 3:2. I want to go very fast, and there's a lot of scriptures you're reading. So stay on toes. Philippians 3:2.
Look out for those dogs.
Look out for those dogs.
Judaizers, legalists.
Uh-huh.
Look out for those mischief makers.
Yes.
Look out for those who mutilate the flesh.
Look out for those who mutilate the flesh. Now, where are these dogs coming from? Exodus 11:4-7. I know there's somebody who is hearing about these dogs for the first day. You're gonna love our God. He's the one who reveals every mystery. Praise the Lord.
And Moses said,
Exodus 11:47.
And Moses said, thus says the Lord.
Thus says the Lord.
About midnight, I will go out into the midst of Egypt.
Yes.
And all the firstborn in the land,
yes,
of Egypt shall die.
Yes.
From the firstborn of Pharaoh,
uh-huh,
who sits on his throne,
yes,
even to the firstborn of the maidservant,
uh-huh,
who is behind the handmill,
yes,
and all the firstborn of beasts,
yes,
there shall be a great cry in all the land of Egypt,
yes,
such as has never been nor ever shall be again.
Yes.
But against any of the Israelites,
but against all the Israelites,
shall not so much as a dog,
yes,
move his tongue against man or beast.
Yes.
That you may know that the Lord makes a distinction,
yes,
between the Egyptians and Israel.
My Bible says, but not even a dog will threaten any of the Israelites, whether man or animal, so that you may know without any doubt and acknowledge how the Lord makes a distinction between Egypt and the Israelites. My God and my Father, we thank you for the entry of your word. As it comes, let it come with a lot of simplicity. Let it become food to somebody who is hungry. Let it become a deliverance to somebody who has been bound. Let it become an uplifter to somebody who has been so down. In Jesus' name we pray. I decree and I declare, as my Father lives, no dog shall bark at your breakthrough. No dog shall bark at your breakthrough. No dog shall bark at your breakthrough.
Amen.
I want you to know that they are satanic dogs. Now, the work of the satanic dogs, I want to take you back to the history of Egyptians. Now, the gods or the kings of Egypt were pharaohs. They were really worshipped. They were worshipping literally everything. That's the reason why, if you look at the plagues that came, the 10 plagues, they touched everywhere. They touched literally everything. That's the reason why the sun became dark. Why? The Israelites, the Egyptians could worship the sun. That's the reason why the River Nile, the gods of the Egyptians, the gods of Pharaoh, were in River Nile. That's the reason why the River Nile was turning to blood. Am I talking to somebody? That's the reason why every plague, everything, it affected each and everything, so that God can deliver the children of Israel with his mighty power. But the Bible is telling us that God told Moses, I am still going to harden the heart of Pharaoh, so that he may know that I am God. I am still going to harden it. I, the Lord, will harden the heart, so that when you leave that place, you are going to live with splendor, you are going to live with mightiness. People will know that I am your God. Am I talking to somebody? And so the reason why Pharaoh was becoming what he was becoming, it was because the hand of God was important. I am here to let somebody know, whatever you are going through, the hand of God is important. Whatever you are going through, the hand of God is important. When you come out, you're going to come out with splendor. When you come out, you're going to come out with power.
Yes.
When you're going to come out, people will testify.
Yes.
There is a God in heaven.
Amen.
That's the reason why the plagues touched There is another power that is behind Moses. That is exactly what is going to happen to your life. That is exactly what is going to happen to your life. When the Lord delivers you, shall we say there is a God behind that power? When the Lord delivers you, they're going to say there is a God behind that man.
Yes.
When the Lord delivers you, stretcher, they're going to say there is a God behind that.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Who are these dogs? Deuteronomy 23:18. Explain to us who are dogs. Who are the dogs?
You shall not bring the hire of a harlot.
Yes.
Or the price of a dog.
Yes.
A sodomite.
Yes.
Into the house of the Lord your God.
Uh-huh.
As payment of a vow.
Yes.
For both of these.
For both of these.
The gift and the
giver. The gift and the giver.
Are an abomination.
Are an abomination.
To the Lord your God.
To the Lord your God. I want to tell you, number one dog is the spirit of lesbianism and gayism. I pray for you, now of your generation, shall meet with satanic doctor in the name of Jesus Christ. Now of your children shall become satanic doctors in the name of Jesus Christ. I speak the loud voice of God, but the church will not embrace satanic doctors.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The reason why the Lord has kept quiet on the church is because of the satanic dogs. I'll show you where satanic dogs are supposed to be. So the reason why the church has become cold is because of the satanic dogs. Today, people can do whatever they want to do. People can fornicate. People can do whatever. People can do whatever they want and still come to church.
I declare, by the hand of Jehovah, let them be exposed. Let the wickedness be exposed.
Yes.
No satanic dog will stand.
Amen.
Chief God was trying to explain to us in the book of Deuteronomy, who are these dogs? Who are these dogs? If you're not careful, your ministry can be brought down by a satanic dog.
Mm.
If you're not careful, your marriage can be brought down by a satanic dog. If you're not careful, your children can become vulnerable because of a satanic dog. Somebody lift up your hands up. Decree and declare, my Father, my God, as soon as I leave it, no satanic dog shall lift me. No dog shall lift me. No dog shall locate me. No dog shall locate me. No dog shall locate me.
Don't locate me in Jesus' name.
Will go to high school. The children of this altar will go to university. The children of this altar will not get this place in Jesus.
Yes.
It will not happen.
Amen.
It will not happen.
Amen.
Because the Bible says, no dog shall meet me. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Who are the dogs? Read for us. Psalms 22:16.
For like a pack of dogs, they have encompassed me.
They have encompassed me.
A company of evildoers.
A company of evildoers
has encircled me.
Have encircled me.
They pierced my hands and my
feet. They have pierced my hands and my feet. Praise the Lord. These are destiny attackers. Destiny attackers. Destiny diverters. Are the ones that are being called dogs. I declare. In the name of Jesus Christ, every satanic dog I promise your power.
Yes, in Jesus'
name. The reason why it is, if there are satanic dogs, there are people who need helpers. There are people who have great connections. But when they are just about to help you, it hurts. There were satanic dogs. A dog can bark at anything. A dog can bark at a shadow. A dog can bark at a wall. A dog, when they bark, the destiny help us go. Put your hand on your head. Declare and declare, my Father and my God.
My Father
and my God.
My Father
and my God. Every satanic dog fighting against my destiny help us. I command you to fall down and die. 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 I command you to fall down and die.
name.
These are people. I remember when God gave me this sermon. This sermon God gave me a long time ago. I remember I was supposed to go to New York. That's why I was supposed to go to New Jersey State College. That's why I was supposed to go to college. Magobadanyo ikaharibika. Little did I know, the frog that backed my destiny was the giver of the ID. It just went like that. Nikakosa ID. Nikaitishwa few birth certificate ya mamangu. Sijui nini nini. The time that I was supposed to enter the college, it went. And it blocked all my doors to go to the state.
I decree and I declare. Every destiny proper.
Yes.
Every destiny proper.
Yes.
Every satanic proper.
Yes.
That is working at your destiny helpers. I command the dog to die.
In Jesus' name. Mm.
Am I talking to somebody?
Yes.
Did this person get to somebody?
Yes.
Now, we have seen number one, the dogs are the sexual, the homosexuals, they are dogs. They have come to invade the body of Christ. That's the reason why we have people who are gay and lesbians, and they are still going to church, and the pastors are not locating them. If you come here,
I'll locate you.
Yes.
I'll locate you. I'll locate you. I'll locate you. And whatever happens to dogs,
that is what.
Mm.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
That's the reason why the church has no voice. That's the reason why people can speak whatever they want to speak. Praise the Lord. Any time that you dream with a dog, in your dream, it is it's a symbol of sexual permission. Any time you dream with a dog, you should wake up and scatter it. It means there is something that is getting polluted in your spiritual man. Your spiritual man is getting attacked. I'm going to let you know in our short one. Praise the Lord. So number one, dogs are homosexuals. Number two, dogs are the people who despise the works of God. These are the people who talk ill. These are the people who celebrate you when you're going down. These are the people that we are calling
dogs.
It's not us, it's the Bible. They are looking in ways to bring you down. They are looking in ways for you to suffer. A dog does not care. It doesn't care whether it's chasing a baby or a grown woman. It will still chase. Am I talking to somebody? And you know what? Can you read for us Psalms 22:20? You hear? When David was praying this prayer, David knew what he was dealing with. What does he say? Psalm 22:20.
Deliver my life from the sword.
Deliver my life from the sword.
My dear life.
My dear life.
From the power of the dog.
From the power of the dog.
The agent of the execution.
The agent of execution. Anytime you see a satanic dog, it's what is done and finish you. It is supposed to execute what is distracted.
I want you to know that satanic dogs are not inherited. You acquire them by your own nature. These are not powers in your father's house. These are things that come your way because you are loud.
Mm.
Praise the Lord.
Yes.
We call them satanic dogs.
Mm.
In our generation, who was a lesbian? Where has it come from? It is something, it is people, they're calling it lifestyle. It's a lie from the devil. You are a dog.
Mm.
You are getting initiated to becoming a dog. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
It is not inherited. It is something that you can say today, I choose a different lifestyle. If you are an avatar, you say today, I choose to stick with my mind. If you are a fornicator, you say today, I choose to stay holy. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Number three. Who are the dogs? Wicked men and enemies of Christ are also referred to as dogs. Anyone who is mocking your God, anyone who is bringing you down, anyone who thinks you are going to end up to nothing, that person, anyone who hates you for no reason. Today we have been talking about love. Somebody who hates you for no reason, that person becomes a dog in the scripture. Praise the Lord. That's how dangerous it is. Read for us Isaiah 56.
and 11. I'm going that fast because of time.
Israel's watchmen are blind.
Yes.
They are all without knowledge.
Yes.
They are all dumb dogs.
Uh-huh.
They cannot bark.
They cannot bark.
Dreaming.
Dreaming.
Lying down.
Lying down.
They love to slumber.
They love to slumber.
Yes.
Yes.
The dogs are greedy.
The dogs are greedy.
They never have enough.
They never have enough.
And such are the shepherds who cannot
account. And such are the shepherds who cannot account.
They have all turned to their own way.
They have all turned to their own way.
Each one to his own gain.
Each one to his own gain.
From every quarter.
From every quarter. Wicked men and evil prophets have been called out. They are just after their own stomach. They are just after feeding themselves. How many people have we seen die of cancer? And there are people with millions and millions of money. And they cannot even bring up a Texas center. I decree and I declare. Whoever God has given our money. Whoever is holding your finances. Whoever the God that is standing on your floor of your trust. Let them fall down and die.
Yes.
As time has to come. And the time is now. That will not entertain rubbish. Let us say the whole truth. There are people who have acquired wealth. They have become greedy. They are servants of God. Somebody is dying of cancer. And you cannot, you know very well, you don't have the gifting of the, you don't have the gift of healing. And you lie to that family. They go and withdraw the money from the bank. May Jehovah watch out with you. May Jehovah catch up together with you.
Yes.
If you are a lying prophet,
yes.
May you be a prophet. May you be a prophet. May you be a prophet.
In Jesus' name.
You are tarnishing the word of God. You are tarnishing the voice of God. God is still speaking now. We don't need a big miracle to know that God is speaking. The miracle of Midian is a miracle enough to show that God is still speaking.
Yes.
You don't have to do to Nestor to show people that God is still speaking.
Yes.
See, God has been whether you do it or not.
Yes.
They are being called dogs. They are lying to people. A dog goes back to the vomit. You lie to people. You are a servant of God and you know God is entrusting you with those people. Then what you are doing to those people, you are ruining them. You are misusing people. You are mishandling people. You are manipulating people. Church is not all about money. There is a God of money. There is a God of money. When you do what is right, if you wish, you can't accept that. That's my God. That's my God. I was praying for another lady in the office. And she told me, "Mom, we have to go and ordain my land. Let's go and do land dedication." And I asked her, "Where?" She told me, "Meru." I said, "Mom, I don't know how to take you there." I told her, "I'll go. I'll go. It doesn't matter whether you fill my car or not. I'll go." Why? It is not about money. The God of the mission will provide. The God of the mission will provide.
Oh,
that is the God I'm talking about. That is the God that is silencing the dog. I pray for you. You're not going to meet an evil prophet.
Yes.
You're not going to meet an evil prophet in your life.
Yes.
Your life will not be manipulated.
Yes.
Your children's life will not be manipulated.
Amen.
Did you go and kiko? You end up in your magic. Asubuhi saa saba na jioni. Na utapata mtoto. Who told you? Who told you? It's a manipulation from the devil. The Bible calls them. It's a very tough topic. This one, and we are going live. We are on YouTube. We are on Facebook. It's a very tough message. Some men of God may throw stones, but that's the truth. That is the true gospel. Praise the Lord. I don't pray for you because you have a seed. No! No! You give a seed because you want to tap and connect to the word. You don't give a seed because a miracle has to come out of the seed. It's a lie from the devil. I may be controversial. Let them call me whatever they want to do. By the grace of God, we have been the least of this place without borrowing any single cent. Because the Lord is under this commission.
Amen.
You don't have to manipulate. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
It is as tough as that. False prophets have been called dogs. The other people who are dogs are people who celebrate in your downfall. People who celebrate when you go down. People who celebrate when you marry your husband. People who celebrate when your children fail to go to school. People who just accuse you and celebrate for nothing. People who join us.
gente atea. Hey, hay una buena. Hay una. Hey, yeah, those ones are before Lord. Second Samuel
16.
When King David came to Bahurim,
uh-huh.
a man of the family of the house of Saul,
Shimei son of Gera,
came out and cursed continually.
Have you ever seen somebody who have just moved to that point and they start accusing you? They start saying, "Oh, mama ni maribu, na hawa kutui." They don't know where you come from. You have just been employed in a particular office, and somebody just raises us from somewhere and just says you have an affair with the boss.
And he cast stones at David.
And he cast stones on David.
And at all the servants of King David.
Uh-huh.
And all the people and all the mighty men were on his right hand.
Uh-huh.
And on his left.
Yes.
Shimei said as he cast.
Yes.
Get out, you man of blood.
Uh-huh.
You base fellow.
Uh-huh.
The Lord has avenged upon you all the blood of the house of Saul.
Uh-huh.
In whose stead you have reigned.
Yes.
And the Lord has delivered the kingdom into the hands of Absalom your son.
Now listen. This man has a lot of information. He's attacking David by his own son. He's telling David, get out of this place, sir. I am celebrating that your son is taking over. These are the people who are happy when your marriage is going down. These are the people who talk to your wife, sir. Leave this guy, is useless, sir. These are the people who talk about you. These are the people who say your children will want to go to school.
No, thank them nothing. Nothing, you're just there. And the guy is coming to tell David, I am happy. And the kingdom is going to be taken from your hands. I am celebrating that your son is fighting with you. These are people who are happy when your family is not working. These are people who are happy when you go for a family meeting. Mukikosana family mzima wana celebrate. And then you go and mention my family because that's what you have. And yes, they are, I saw it coming. They are celebrating over the dance.
Behold, the calamity is upon you because you are a bloody man.
Uh-huh.
Then said David's nephew,
yes,
Abishai son of Zeruiah.
Abishai stood up. He said what?
Abishai son of Zeruiah to the king.
Yes.
Why should this dead dog curse my
master? Why should this dead dog curse my master? Praise the Lord. Anyone who is accusing you falsely, yes. Anyone who is speaking about your family, anyone who is celebrating your downfall, anyone who is celebrating that your marriage is not going, anyone who is celebrating that your wife has been sacked, they are dead.
Their heads shall be cut off.
In
Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Let me tell you one thing. Until you wage war, Christianity is not fanfare. Christianity is warfare.
Yeah.
It will never give you what you deserve.
It will give you what you demand.
It will never. It will give you what you demand. When I realize they are dogs, when I realize they are satanic dogs, I scatter them. I command them to paralyze. I command them to lack voice. I command them to become toothless.
Yes.
Let them not bite anybody. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
There are people who celebrate the downfall of a particular family. There are people who celebrate that you're not making it in life. There are people who just have, if right now, you ask this guy, Shimei, if go and read on your own, 2 Kings 2, 36 to 46, you see how Shimei died. He died painfully. That is the way they shall be cut off their head. That is the way they shall be silenced. In the name of Jesus Christ, whoever makes you cry, they shall cry your tears.
Yes.
Let me tell you one thing. Jesus said, from the days of John the Baptist
till now,
the kingdom of God. You know why Jesus said that? Do you know that? You know why Jesus said that? John the Baptist was a powerful man.
Yes.
But he died like a chicken.
That's true.
His head was asked for by a guy on a platter.
I see.
And Joseph could have, John the Baptist could have scattered that blood, could have done all the enemy. Jesus said, I refuse you to die like that. I declare.
Yes.
As you make war on the enemy, let them be paralyzed. Let them be blinded.
It's the word of God.
It is the word of God.
Mm.
Now, who are the dogs? All backsliders. All backsliders are called dogs. That is why I normally tell people, never ever taste God. You hear what happens? Read for us. 2 Peter 2:20-21. Have you read that? Have you read that? Please read it. I have so many scriptures. I'm running with time.
For if, after they have escaped the pollutions of the world through the full personal knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus
Christ. Yani inamaanisha ukishatoka kwa ulimwengu umejua haki na ukweli wa Mungu, alafu sasa umekubali Mwenyezi Mungu, ehe.
They
by your personal knowledge, not for your parents. Mm-hmm. You have made a personal choice. I want to know Jesus. Ehe, then
they again become entangled in them.
They again become entangled. They go back to the vomit. What happens?
And are overcome.
And they are overcome.
Their last condition is worse.
Their last condition is worse.
For them than the first.
For them than the first. Kama ulikuwa mlevi, ukibackslide, unakuwa mlevi. Yani inakuwa na saba. Praise the Lord. Read for us Revelation. Revelation 22:15. I love my God. You know, the prayer that David prayed in the book of Psalms 22:16, oh Lord, rescue me from the powers of the dog, is a very, very powerful. Listen to what the Bible says. Revelation 22:15.
But without are the dogs.
But without, or outside, whatever person says, but outside are the dogs.
And those who practice sorcery.
And those who practice sorcery.
Magic arts.
And impurity.
The lute.
Adulterers.
And the murderers.
And idolaters.
And everyone who loves and deals in falsehood.
They have been called what? Outside our what?
The dogs.
Let me tell you why. I want to let somebody know. Some of us, we may not know the foundation that we came from. Some of the parents who gave back to us were dogs. They were adults. Some of us, we are children of a polygamous
home.
Some of us, we are children of another woman. My father gave back to us, na katuacha, na tukalea, kwa kuwa watu. So we became a product of adultery. Some of us, we have been fornicating without knowing the consequences of fornicators. I am not here to judge anybody, but I'm here for somebody to cry unto the Lord. I am here for somebody to cry unto the Lord. I want somebody to put their right hand on their chest.
Yes.
And declare this prayer. Oh Lord, deliver my soul.
Deliver my soul.
From the powers of the dogs. In the name of Jesus Christ. Pray that prayer. Oh Lord, deliver my soul. Oh Lord, deliver my soul. From the powers of dogs. In the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, deliver my soul. From the powers of the
dogs. Some of us even
did fornication. We did masturbation. Without knowing they are dogs. I'll show you what dogs do. How do dogs enter? And when they enter, what happens? Praise the Lord. I only have 15 minutes. Will you allow me?
Yes.
Will you allow me?
Yes.
Only 15 minutes. I want you to know the strategy of the spirit of dogs. There are only three strategies. I'm going to close there. But on Sunday, God willing, I am going to handle the empty points of the spirit of dogs. Okay? Will you allow me to handle it on Sunday? Let me make it a series so that I don't rush and complete without somebody getting it. Praise the Lord. The desire of this ministry is that we may know the truth and the truth will set us free.
Yes.
When you are teaching your children, you not only tell them sex is not good, let them know biblically it's a dog. When you tell a child like that, you have already made a generation for yourself. Your child will have chastity. Another child will have chastity. Another child, wakipatana kwa ndoa, hakuna ma spirit husband and spirit wives. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
If I knew what I know today, I could have closed my Jerusalem. I could have waited upon God. I could not have tangatada that. And
I could not have done it. I could have waited on God. But since God is giving that knowledge to us, we'll become better. We'll become better. We will become better. We'll become better. Some of us, we have even thrown away children. We gave birth and we threw away children. There are ladies somewhere who are struggling with your child. There's a lady somewhere who is struggling with your child. You have been named a dog. So, the Bible says, when the woman cried to Jesus and told Jesus, please give my child something. I want my child to be healed. Jesus said, I cannot give the food of the children to the dogs. So some of us, we are not receiving the blessings of God because we are
dogs.
Because we are
dogs.
Now you have to talk in this church now. You have to talk now. Let us be told the truth. Let me not come here and tell you, you are going to drive a Mercedes first. I receive. You are going to remove your handkerchief with a gun. I receive. You are going to receive the food of the children cannot be given to the dogs. Is that serious? So we continue saying, God is no longer performing miracles. Number one strategy of the spirit of dogs. The spirit, it is a spirit of outside. It is a spirit that will never allow you to stay somewhere enclosed. Even if you build a kennel for the dog, it will still cry to God. It will still cry to God. It is a spirit of outside. Praise the Lord. It is a spirit. It is a spirit that will say, you don't belong here. You know, it is a spirit that can bring shame. It brings shame. Read for us the story of the 10 virgins. I'll show you. It is a spirit that makes you go near breakthrough. You are just seeing a miracle is here. You are seeing this is my job. You are seeing this is my interview. I am supposed to go, then you miss. It is the spirit of the Lord. Matthew. Matthew chapter 25.
1 to 13. But can you go where we have the foolish ladies? I don't want to deal with the wise girls. Who is the foolish?
And from verse 8,
yes.
And the foolish said to the wise,
uh-huh.
Give us some of your oil.
Give us some. I want somebody to know that oil is grace. Praise the Lord. Oil is grace. It didn't mean that the oil is overfuta. The Bible says that the word of the Lord is a lamp to my feet. Okay? So when you take the Bible literally, utafikiria ni tana na mafuta ya taa. But if you go theologically, it means they lacked grace. The spirit of the dog make you lack grace. You can mingle with very mighty in this land, but end up back in your house in Kagemi. Because the spirit of the dog is saying, you are meant to be
Kagemi.
You are meant to be outside. You are meant to be outside. What happened after they lacked the grace?
Give us some of your oil.
Give us some of your oil.
For our lamps are going out.
For our lamps are being didn't have the word. I decree and declare, as the word of God is being spread to you, yes. You are going to carry the grace. Yes. The grace of this altar will work for you. Yes. The grace that is working for this ministry will work for you.
Amen.
They lacked the word and they lacked the grace. Then what happened?
But the wise replied.
But the wise said,
there will not be enough for us and for you.
It is not going to be enough.
Go instead to the dealers and buy for yourselves.
Tokeni wapi? Tokeni wapi?
Nje.
Tokeni wapi?
Nje.
They went out. There's a spirit that is saying, here you cannot live. If you get a good house, the spirit is saying, you belong, you have the satanic spirit. Here you cannot live.
Chases you away.
It chases you away. There are people, there are wives who are chased away by the dog spirit. You are so good to your wife, you look back and you wonder, what happens to me? What is going on? You have married twice. The spirit of the dog is saying the lady, you cannot stay here. Interview, and then you are looking for a dress to wear
and you cannot locate the dress. It means the spirit of God is haunting you. If you dream going to church and you cannot locate the dress to go to church, the spirit of the dog is pursuing you. If you dream, you go to a very big congregation and you're supposed to minister. Ama, you are a singer and you are a minister. You're supposed to minister. Alafu kipoa mic wimbe wimbo inapotea. The spirit of
dogs.
If you go, you want to preach, then you look for a particular Bible verse in the dream and you cannot locate the Bible verse, the spirit of dog is pursuing you. If you dream, somebody snatching the Bible from you, and you look for the Bible you cannot see, or somebody coming and throwing a piece of your Bible, there is the spirit of the dog that is pursuing you. Praise the Lord. If you dream with a dog biting you, what it does, it releases the poison of the dog. So your spirit man start dying slowly. And the reason why, if you ever dream with a dog, you're supposed to wake up and scatter. Why? The dog will make sure if you're a singer, you start hating going to church. If you're an intercessor, you start hating praying. If you're a pastor, you don't make sermons. You don't pray. You know, it means the dog came and scattered your life. Say, my father, my father.
My father, my father.
My father, my God. Every satanic daughter. Father, keep my destiny. I command you to collapse and die. You hear people who are in the church and they are saying, my mother told me just to give birth to a baby. Even if other man are not coming, my mother will take care of my baby. Then it's not your mother that loves you so much, you are bringing up a bastard. And the Bible says the bastard child shall not enter the gathering of the saints to the third generation.
That's true.
Deuteronomy 23:5. Deuteronomy 23:2. A child of a bastard. So what the devil is doing, the devil, I'll show you on Sunday some of the entry points of the satanic dog. Some of them are the places you go. The devil will make sure that he has organized a very good celebration only for you. Only the devil does not care whether he gets us as a church. He only needs one person. So the devil will make sure he organizes a party. And you are a son of God, you appear. The Bible says in the book of Psalms 91:11 that God shall command his angels to watch over us. Mm. There are some places you go to, that's all. The angels will not go with you.
That's true.
They will stand at the door.
Mm.
Yes, you have been given angels to watch over you, but they will not go. This is mama hapo. Zikungoje. Because there are places angels cannot go. I pray on Sunday you don't miss. I pray on Sunday you don't miss.
Yes.
We're gonna get to know the entry point of these demons.
Mm.
Some of our dreams, we dream roaming in the forest. Unaota unazunguka tu kwa forest. It means your spiritual life is an attack. The only thing that roams around is nowhere to go is a dog.
Lost. Spirit of wonder.
You wonder how? Upwa ya kangemi. Inezetoka kangemi yene kawawa.
They wonder.
They wonder. That is why you see yourself in the forest. You are going around. You are going around. Alafu, ukienda kona ni kama unana kajia unamuka. You have been out.
Say, my father, my father.
My father, my God.
My father, my God.
My father, my God.
Any satanic dog attack.
Over my life.
I command an attack right now. Be nullified.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
If you dream with a dog licking you, what a umbwa and a kulamba lamba, it means you have some demonic sexual agents.
Pursuing.
They are pursuing you. If you came into a marriage and you never broke the soul ties, if you came to a marriage, you'll be dealing with dogs. Why? The soul tie. We have called them dogs because the Bible has called them dogs. They are adulterers. They are fornicators. If you came in a marriage, and that's the reason why I'll be preaching in a dinner.
at 6:80. And I want to tell them to be very, very careful. The title of that dinner is, and very soon I'm doing a couple's dinner. Couple's dinner.
Amen.
Couple's dinner. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Couple's dinner.
Amen.
Amen. Be careful with the little foxes that destroy the vineyard. Some of the little foxes are not demonic. We are the people who brought them to ourselves.
That's true.
What is breaking the marriages today are two things. Number one, yourself and ancestral powers. Hakuna bibi mbaya na hakuna mwanaume mbaya. So if you assume some things in your marriage, unaangalia bibi yako hivi unaona tukienda ushago mama yake anafanya nini? That is a little fox. Deal with it. Die. Die. Kill it. The Bible teaches us about how to kill the foxes in the book of Judges, chapter 25. How to kill foxes. Zinaunganishangwa mkia. Zinawashwa moto, zinaingia zikichomeka. Make sure that you buy everything that you see is not coming to life. Yes. Because your marriage should work. I decree and I declare that.
Yes.
As the Lord my God liver, no satanic God shall appear. No satanic God that shall back her. Clear your breakthrough in Jesus.
Amen.
Satanic thoughts are very dangerous. You will walk in the life of a Christian and you will never realize where am I going wrong. You think that you are a very good tither, but when the satanic dog is pursuing you, you will never see the fruit of tithing. Why? I want read for us. Read for us. As you're standing, I want to show you that God cannot bless what he has already cast. Praise the Lord. I want to show you that any time that is a spirit of dog that is pursuing you, it means when you come from such a generation and then you enter into business with somebody who is a child of God, your business will go down for sure. It will go down. The Bible talks about Jehoshaphat. He was a very great king. He had done mighty things, and the Bible says that God rest all around. He knew how to wage war. But the Bible tells me that King Jehoshaphat entered into business with the son, with King Ahab. Remember, King Ahab was given a punishment that they shall be eaten by the dogs. Praise the Lord. So that's the reason why God is not that God is not blessing businesses. But the question is, who is your partner in business? The spirit of dog will not allow you it to profit.
Huh? Even be married by somebody.
Even be married from that life.
Mm.
That is why the little foxes. What do I have to go bar at an anniversary? At Suzy, the biblical concept of the little foxes, the men don't fit. Who do you marry? Who are you relating with? Can you read for us? Have I given you the scripture? Second Kings. Second Kings 9:10. I hope it's that one. First Kings 21:22-25. First Kings 21:22-25. It is not that one. Second Kings 9:10. It is okay. Your husband. No, yes, Second Chronicles. Thank you. Thank you, Bible scholars. Thank you, Bible scholars. Second Chronicles 20:37. God bless you. Yeah, I got it. Second Chronicles 20:35-37.
After this, Jehoshaphat, king of Judah,
yes,
joined with Ahaziah, king of Israel,
yes,
who did very wicked. He joined him in building ships,
yes,
to go to Tarshish,
yes,
building them in Ezion Geber.
Uh-huh.
Then Eliezer, son of Dodavahu of Maresha prophesied against Jehoshaphat saying,
Because you have joined Ahaziah,
the Lord will destroy your works.
The Lord will destroy your works.
So the ships were wrecked and unable to go to Tarshish.
This is my question. The same business that Jehoshaphat did, the same business Solomon did, and Solomon prospered. 1 Kings 9:26-28. I want you to know some of the entry point of the dog spirit is the friends that you have. Some of our friends.
1 Kings 9:22-26. But Solomon made no slaves of the Israelites.
Yes.
There were the soldiers. His officials. Attendants. Commanders. Captains.
Yes.
Chariot officers.
Yes.
And horsemen.
These
were the chief officers over Solomon's work.
Yes.
550 who had charge of the people who did the work.
Yes.
But Pharaoh's daughter came up out of the city of David to her house which Solomon had built for her. Then he built the Milo. Three times a year, Solomon offered burnt offerings.
Yes.
And peace offerings on the altar he built to the Lord. And he burnt incense with them.
Yes.
Before the Lord.
So
he finished the house.
Yes.
And King Solomon made a fleet of ships. In Ezion Geber.
Go and take the book of Chronicles. You see the same place that Solomon made the ship. It's the same place Jehoshaphat made the ship.
Which is beside Elot.
Yes.
On the shore of the Red Sea.
And then he used to do what? 28.
And Hiram sent with the fleet his servants.
Yes.
Shipmen who had knowledge of the sea.
How many times in a year?
3 times.
3 times in a year. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Mtu anaanza biashara kama yako. Anauza wewe unapaki umefungua mdomo. My question is, who are you associating with? That is the entry point of the dogs. As long as a clan or a family is carrying that spirit of the dog, if you associate with them, you become one. I pray for you that the Lord will silence every voice of the devil in the name of Jesus Christ. Every satanic voice of the demon, every satanic voice of the doctor, I command the voice right now to be silenced. I pray for you that every dog that is barking at the place of your breakthrough.
Yes.
Every dog that is barking at the door to your canal.
Yes.
I command that dog to fall down and die.
In Jesus' name.
When the dog is in operation, you hear your wife telling you, Adonaiza kukuacha. You are not the only man. Unasikia bwana anambia hivi. Na siku hizi umezeeka. Amezeeshwa na nini alikuzalia? It is the satanic dog that is working. If you have given birth for somebody, hata kama nikatoto kako na mwaka moja, you have become one. So what is that voice? Inapeanga wa mama ujeuri. Nitaenda! Mimi nitaenda, satanic dog. Umbwa hata ukiichapa, inakimbianga kama imeingisha mkia hapa na inapiga makelele tu ikikimbia. They are dogs that don't bark, but they pursue. They can pursue you. There are things that are silent in your life. Unasikia uwezi kaa bila mwanaume. It's a silent dog. It's not barking, but inakupatia joto kwa mwili. Unasikia, ani, nikikaa bila mwanaume nasikia kutikuna. It is a satanic
dog.
You need to work on it. You need to tell your Jerusalem boy, keep quiet. Hata kama ni ice cream, ni ice utaenda uchukue uweke. Uamwambie wewe, tafadhali wa satanic dog. I command you right now, keep quiet.
In Jesus' name. It has ears.
Dogs have ears. They will listen. When the satanic dog is in operation, you don't know whether the man you're dating is a married man or not. You just say, see me nataka kulipa rent. Why? It is in operation. I pray for you. Now in this church will go amiss. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray with my eyes open. I decree and I declare. The God of this commission will protect your marriage. The God of this commission will protect your youthfulness. The God of this commission will protect your spouse.
they close. God only answers prayer, not of satanic doubt. God answers prayer of genuine people who are rightfully. There is a woman, she went to church, and she went to church, but the pastor gave a prayer point. And the prayer point was, oh God, give me divine insurance. Give me divine insurance. The lady prayed, she prayed. She felt like, I think I need the prayer. She prayed. Then she said, amen. After 2 weeks, the husband was involved in an accident. Everybody else died. Only that man came out. I want you to know that kama wewe ni mpango wa kanda na unaombea wewe bwana yako, it will not happen. You die. Why? The satanic dogs have to be pursued. They have to be pursued. The reason why God delivered this man is because their wife, the real wife who was praying, was the right wife. Usidanganye na mtu atakaleta mbegu hapa tufunge bwana wenyewe. These are very, very, it's a tested out, and God can do whatever we ask, but we will not use your money. Kufunga mpua wenyewe. So if you know you are living with a person who is not your husband, if you know you are living with somebody who is not your wife, no matter what kind of prayers you say, we pray for you, it will not happen. That's because true. God does not give the food of the children to the
dogs.
Lift up your hands.
Say, Lord Jesus,
Lord Jesus,
rescue my soul
from
the powers of the powers, from the powers of the dogs. Say, Lord Jesus, rescue my soul from the powers of the dogs. Pray that prayer, pray that prayer. You may not know what the devil is planning for you. You may not know what the devil is planning. You may not know where you're going to be married. You may not know who is going to marry. You may not know who is going to marry your children. You may not know who is going to marry your husband. You may not know who is going to bring us away from.
Rescue us from the powers of God.
Pray for your brothers. Pray for your sisters.
Yes, Lord.
Pray for your spouses. Pray for your sisters, but they're not going to fall. They're not going to fall to the hands of the doctor. Your sisters will not get married. Your sisters will not fall in the hands of the doctor. As a church, as the employer, we are not going to fall to the powers of the doctor. Pray for your children, if not children. Pray that God will not allow homosexuality to come here. They're not going to fall to the powers of the doctor. They're not going to fall to the powers of the doctor. They're not going to fall to the powers of the doctor. Oh, somebody pray unto the Lord. 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 Oh, we pray for the children of this nation. We pray for the children of this nation. They're not going to fall to the hands of the enemy.
Of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Another healthy point is what you eat. The Bible says in the book of John 6:56-59, I want us to close the sermon. It is a long sermon. We pray on Sunday, God will help us to finish. John chapter 6. Some of the healthy point of the satanic thoughts is what you feed on. There is a saying that says you become what you eat. Praise the Lord. I want to thank you because of the blood of Jesus. I want to thank you because of the body of Jesus. That you become what you eat. You become what you eat. As you take the Holy Communion, the Lord is going to nourish you. The Lord is going to refresh you. The Lord is going to give you life. Where the dogs were saying, we will not leave. The Lord is saying, let my daughter live. Where the dogs say that you are going to be vomited, the word of the Lord is saying, let Reuben live and not die. I decree and I declare, by the word of Jehovah, we become what we eat. You shall leave.
Okay.
For us, John 6, 56-59, as you prepare your heart. You know, this is not a condemning church. This is a church where we accommodate everybody, but you change. You tell the Holy Spirit of God, as I take the Holy Communion, I know I am a dog. I know there are things that I have done in my life. I know I used to be a masturbator. I know I used to be a fornicator. Oh Lord, remove the power of the dogs in me. In the name of Jesus Christ. Speak for us. As we prepare our spirit.
He who feeds on my flesh and drinks my blood
dwells continually in me
and I in him just as the living Father sent me,
yes,
and I live by the Father,
yes,
even so whoever continues to feed
on me, whoever continues to feed in me
shall live through and because of me,
shall live through and because of me.
This is the bread that came down from heaven.
Yes, this is the bread.
It is not like the manna which our forefathers ate,
yes,
and yet died,
and they were destroyed.
He who takes this bread,
he who takes the bread as food,
shall live forever.
Amen.
Father, we thank you, we bless you. It doesn't matter what the satanic dogs are saying outside there. Yes, I know some of us were overwhelmed by the powers of the dogs. But today you are saying, when you take your body, we shall live. When you take your body, we shall live. I declare somebody is living here, oh God. Somebody who has been living under condemnation is getting delivered tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. Somebody who has been in the bondage of masturbation is getting relieved in the name of Jesus Christ. Somebody who is in the bondage of idolatry. Somebody who has been in the bondage of fornication is getting delivered tonight in the name of Jesus. When you take the body, we will live.
Yes, Jesus.
We will live.
Yes, Lord.
We will live.
Yes, Jesus.
Some of the entry points of the satanic dogs is what we feed on.
Yes, Lord.
God, some of us have fed on a lot of things. Others, God, we thought we were making love, and we went ahead and sucked the body organs, the sexual organs, which is a sin, oh God. We consumed the dirty things of this world, Jesus. Some of us, God, we drank poison. Some of us were beer takers. Some of us, we took even concussion from a witch doctor. But you have told us, dear Lord, those are dogs. And so if you are not careful, we may be locked out. If you are not careful, we call upon the blood of Jesus. Somebody plead mercy. Somebody plead the blood of Jesus. 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 There is a great move. There is a great move of the Holy Spirit. There is a great move of the Holy Spirit. There is a great move. There is a great move. Oh, Jesus, the power. The power of the blood. 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 Oh, we contaminate. We shall live. Some of us, Jesus, we were given concussion by witch doctors.
Yes.
And we took it, those are dogs.
Yes.
And if we are not careful, we may be chased out. Oh, Jesus, we will not be locked out. We will not be locked out. We will not be locked out. The spirit of outside will not see us. Will not see us in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Jesus. Oh, God,
we bless you. We bless you.
Yes, Lord.
We bless you. Take all the glory. Take all the honor.
Yes, Lord.
It belongs to you.
Yes, Jesus.
As we take the Holy Communion, let it come. Let it come.
Yes.
And speak the seven voices of
yes,
the blood.
Yes,
let the seven voices of the blood be heard. Jesus. Let the seven voices of the blood be heard.
Yes, Jesus.
In Jesus' name.
Thank you, Father.